Hello everyone! Today we're going to create this scene, painted in Krita, and animated in Blender. Hello! This video is a little different. I'm not usually in front of the camera, but I thought I would just invite you into my space, and in celebration of reaching 20,000 subscribers, thank you all for that, it's mind-blowing, I would just take the time to talk a little bit about my journey with animation, and specifically graphics tablets. Okay, so this was my first ever tablet. It's a Wacom Bamboo Fun. It's really, really simple and quite old, but it was a huge step up from just using a mouse and keyboard. You really don't need anything more than this to make great art, but things can be a little more comfortable. So at some point I decided to save up and I bought a secondhand display tablet, the Cintiq 13 HD. This made things a lot more comfortable being able to draw directly onto the screen, and it served me well for many, many years. I then recently upgraded to another display tablet, the Cintiq 22 HD. This allowed for a larger working space, which allowed me to draw from my shoulder rather than my wrist or elbow. Again, making things just a little more comfortable. A couple of weeks ago, Huion reached out to me and they've sent me their Kamvas Pro 13 2.5K to review. So that's what I'll be using for this project. I'll be putting it through its paces, and at the end of the video, I'll show you what I found in the box, what it was like to set up, and giving you a list of pros and cons. In the meantime, let's get into this project. So this project, I wanted to make an awesome Halloween-themed character. So I began by creating some thumbnails, and ultimately I chose this first one. So I scaled up the thumbnail and began sketching over the character, trying to get an idea of the 3D forms and underlying structure. With this done, I began drawing the character with all the final details. I then began to work on the environment, again trying to get a good understanding of the 3D space. Before adding color to the character, I first filled in a simple background to give me a lighting context when choosing colors for the character. So once I've rendered everything out in more detail, I need to separate everything onto their own layers. I could have planned this from the beginning, and for the environment I did. But for the character, I wanted to have a smoother painting experience by painting on just one layer and then now separating it. After exporting each layer to their own PNG image, I began importing them into a Blender file using the Import Images as Plane add-on. Each of these images automatically comes in as a simple plane with four vertices and the image as a texture. So we need to enter edit mode, and using the knife tool, I cut out the silhouette, and to improve the deformation, add edges on the inside of the shape, following the 3D form of the image. You can see this particularly in her face, where I use similar topology as you would with a 3D head. Once everything was cut out and layered in the correct order, it was time to begin rigging. I chose to keep things pretty simple. In the past, I've approached rigging with a modular design, adding a deformation armature, and adding mechanisms and controls on top of that. In this case, I tried to keep things really simple. If there could be one bone to deform the mesh and to control for animation, then I kept it as one bone. With that said, I still added some systems to allow for easier animation, stretching the legs to the foot bone, or cancelling out the rotation for the head or the arm, to prevent me from needing to counter animate. So I began to animate. Again, I kept it simple. Ultimately, this is really just an illustration with a little life breathed into it, rather than a robust rig for large scale animation. This is similar to the splash art you might see in a loading screen for a video game. With the character done, I wanted to add a little more movement to the environment. I began by adding a little wave to the vine next to her, but again, I wanted more, so using the shader editor, I made a ghostly spirit escaping the castle in the background. So, after a few tweaks, here we are with the final project. I'm really happy with it, and I hope to do more painting like this in the future, as I really enjoyed it. So now we're going to look at the tablet that I used, what comes with it, and what are the pros and cons of using it. So before we get into the nitty-gritty of what you'll find in the box, I want to focus on the styluses. These are the styluses that came with my Wacom tablets. They look just like a regular pen, but they have two programmable buttons and a nib for the graphite equivalent and an eraser at the other end. They come in a stand that can hold the stylus vertically or horizontally. This stand has a felt base which protects your surface, but also allows it to slide around quite a bit. And you can unscrew the top to reveal some spare nibs and a nib removal tool. Soft nibs and hard nibs. The Huion pen is a little bit different. Still looks like a regular pen and has two buttons and a nib, but it doesn't have an eraser. It has this cool tapered design. This doesn't bother me as I don't use the eraser on my Wacom tablets. The stand is flatter and more oval-like, but it can still hold it vertically and horizontally. It has a rubber base, which still protects your surface, but doesn't allow it to slide very well, which is nice. You can also undo the top. It's a little more tricky on this one, but it also reveals a nib removal tool and hard and soft spare nibs. So this is everything else that you'll find in the box. There's the tablet itself with a nice matte finish and some programmable keys down the side. To connect it to your computer, you have a few options. For older devices like mine that don't support USB-C, you have an HDMI loom style cable with one side for the tablet and an HDMI cable, a data cable, and a power cable. If your device does support USB-C, then all you need is this USB-C cable. It goes directly from your tablet to your computer. However, if your computer doesn't provide enough power through your USB port, there's an additional cable for power with a handy extension cable in case it's not long enough. It also comes with a smudge guard, which you can wear to help protect your screen and provide a smoother drawing experience. I'd highly recommend using it. It also comes with a microfiber cloth to clean the screen and some instructions. Nice metal stand that is adjustable and has different levels you can place it at. I think it's a lot nicer than the stand for my Cintiq 13 HD. Has a lip for the tablet to be placed on, so it's really, really simple to use. So while we play the final product in the background here, I'm just going to go through some pros and cons that I found while using this tablet. So on the positive side, it's really nice. The screen is high quality, it's vibrant, has a matte finish, and it's really high resolution. I found that the drawing experience was really smooth, and the stand is really high quality, being metal. Also, if you have USB-C on your device, this tablet is pretty portable. I like that they included a smudge guard, though I chose to use the one that I already had. Also, I like the stylus design. Next up, though it's very standard, I love that it supports Windows, Linux, and Mac. And finally, being that this tablet was given to me, I don't really feel like I can comment on the price, but it is really good. Even though I bought my other two tablets secondhand, they were each more expensive than this one is brand new, so that's pretty cool. On the negative side, the loom has a strange design, which sticks up a little if it's set up for a right-hander, or if you have it set up for left-handed use, it can even stop the tablet from resting on the stand. It's not so bad if you bring the cable around the front, but that isn't always feasible. So I chose to prop it up on a piece of wood, and that solved the problem. This critique is especially annoying because it could be easily solved by just placing the plugs in the center rather than at the bottom or the top. I also noticed that even though the drivers are available for almost any operating system, the Linux drivers are a little confusing on their site. If you click here, you will install the Debian version of the driver, but what confused me for a long time was that if you click on older versions, it actually shows other versions, and they're not outdated at all. Here you can find the tar.xz driver, which can be used for other Linux distributions like Fedora. Finally, all display tablets tend to have some degree of offset between where the pen is and where the cursor on screen appears, which you can see most prominently at the corners. However, I felt that on this tablet, it was a little stronger than it is on my other tablets, but it wasn't so much that it got in the way. Overall, this tablet does a great job, and I've been using it even outside of this project just because I like it so much. It's really high quality and for a really great price. There are a few drawbacks and design quirks, but nothing major. Moving forward, I think I'll continue to use my larger Wacom tablet, but only because of the larger drawing area. In almost every other aspect, the Huion Kamvas Pro 13 2.5K is a bit better. And I look forward to having such a high quality option when traveling or just not at my desk. Thank you so much for watching. I just finished my Bachelor of Animation, so you can also expect to see a few videos on that coming up soon, including my final short film. In the meantime, I will see you around. Thanks!